That was Little Frog in the Well. Today we are going to do page number 40. First of all, read me. Some of the important features of the conversation are location, scene, character, thoughts and feelings, and situation. These are just extra information for you whenever you want to write a dialogue. So you must know about the location, where that conversation is taking place, and what are the characters that are there who are conversing, and what are the thoughts and feelings that are being presented, what is the situation. When you know all these things, then you can write a dialogue. So it was just an extra information. Then we come to the language corner. Number one, think in English. We have already discussed that the approach of this book is that we have to concentrate on the skills. Skill of speaking English, skill of writing English, skill of listening comprehension. So there are some tips that are given over here to increase your proficiency of English. Think in English means you have to think in the target language. When you want to express something, don't think in Urdu or in your native language, but try to think in English, then your expression will improve. So this is the meaning of this expression. Think in English, thinking in the target language, and obviously the target language in this way is English, is very important. Once a milestone is achieved, speaking becomes easier. When we speak, then first of all we must think, not in Urdu then to translate it, but first of all we should try to think in English. That will improve your expression. Follow the given four steps to improve thinking and speaking in English. Number one, learn vocabulary in phrases, not single words. This is very important. When we learn the things, always learn in phrases. Phrases means in group of words, not in single words. It is not possible for anyone to learn English, to learn so many words. It is not possible. We can learn certain words only. And when we learn, we have to learn the things in expressions, in small chunks, not in the whole. So try to learn, try to read the things also in chunks. Similarly, try to understand the things also in chunks. Means not the single words, but in complete phrases. Phrases means a group of words. This is also when we are reading, we are actually assimilating the group of words, not just the words. People who just concentrate on the single words, they are the lazy learners. And the people who are fast learners, they always take the things in chunks, in small parts. So learn the things, understand the things in group of words, not individually. Group of words help us catch expression, which are commonly used in conversation, whereas single words only provide information. Single words, just the meanings. So we have to learn the things in expressions, in simple phrases, not in the words. Start using new words and expression. We should not stop ourselves from speaking in English, as practice makes us perfect. Obviously, try to speak English. This is the only way by which you can improve your expression. This is the only way. You might have observed the people who are living in the English-speaking countries. They learn English quite fast as compared to us, because our surrounding, that is not congenial, that is not helping us. So try to speak English. You may do that with one of your friend. You may do that with your father, with your mother, with your sister. So practice, that is very important. There must be no shyness when you are speaking English. We can commit mistakes. This is very common. But don't feel shy. And try to speak whatever the expression you have, what are the words you have, what are the phrases you have. Try to speak that. Get an English speaking friend or partner, the same thing. It's always easier to improve English when we speak with a friend, when you are speaking with a friend, when you are speaking with your father or your mother or your brother, then it is always easy. talk to yourself, describe whatever is happening around you in English to yourself. This gives you extra practice before you start explaining things to other people. You might have observed that some of the speakers, some of the people who deliver speeches at different levels, they also use the mirrors. They stand in front of the mirrors and express their feelings and emotions. In this way, they can improve that. Actors, they also do the same kind of practice. So we can also do that. We can talk to ourselves. Whatever we have learned, whatever the expressions we have, in this way also we can improve our speaking skill. So all these things are to improve your speaking skill, to improve your comprehension skills. Even you can record your things, whatever you are speaking, you can record that, and after that you can listen and you can improve. In few days you can do that. This is not a very big deal. You can do that with the help of one of your friend, with the help of your family. You can do that. First of all, you have to make it sure that yes, I can. So try to think in English and then use the new expressions, new words that you have learned, and then you may take help from your friend who is speaking English, and then you can talk to yourself. These are the four steps by which you can improve your speaking skills. Then we come to the next point. This is a monologue writing. Now, what is the meaning of monologue? It is self-speaking. The speech, monologue is speech we make to ourselves. Guess the monologues of the different animals from the story, the frog in the well. Fill in the speech bubbles below. An example is given to help you. For example, in the first bubble, frog that says, "My well is the biggest place in the world." Or you can say, "My well is the most beautiful place in the world," that is said by frog. Then the birds, they were, yes, the frog that does not understand the importance of flying, and he does not understand the beauties of nature. Then the yellow sparrow, that might be thinking, "The world outside the well is so beautiful," and the frog does not know the importance of these beautiful things. So in this way, you can fill in the bubbles. Just a short exercise of monologue writing. Monologue is just the self-speaking. Your thoughts when you are speaking. This is very common in dramas and plays. You can see the characters that are delivering different kinds of monologues. We know sometimes the writer also reveals the story through monologues, or the thoughts of a character through monologues. So it's a very important dramatic technique also that is used by different writers. Then we come to the task. Write a monologue for yourself when the teacher asks you to speak for a minute on my best friend, my home, my favorite game. You may consult the list of expressions given below to plan your work. For example, when you are going to start on the topic I am going to choose is, "We are here today to look at, I would like to tell you something about." Then in the middle sentence, maybe, "First I would like to say a few words about," then I'll move on to, "Now I'd like to draw your attention to the fact that," in conclusion you can say, and finally, to round it off, I'll, "Well, let me just sum up my main points. Thank you very much for your attention." These are the expressions that can be used for the conclusion. This activity will be done when we will meet, inshallah, in class. But you can do the practice at home also. It's a short kind of speech actually. For example, when you say that my best friend, when you want to deliver a monologue, you can say that the topic I am going to choose today is my best friend. I am going to tell you something about my best friend. My best friend is so and so. You can mention the name. And she is a very intelligent girl. She helps me all the time. While doing, we do our homework together, and she belongs to a well-to-do family, and she is living beside my house. We are also friends at home, and she is very active also. We go for the walk daily with my friend, and then you can say, okay, in this way you can finally conclude. You can write two or three lines on this, and then you can write about the conclusion that thank you very much for the attention. Similarly, you can write about my home, My home, I live in Islamabad. Islamabad is the capital of Pakistan. We are lucky people that we are living in this city because it's a very clean city, and my home is also situated in the center of Islamabad. We have all the facilities like electricity, like gas and water supply. My home is very neat and clean. My mother always keeps my home clean, and I live with my brothers and sisters and father in this home, and we all live very happily over there. In this way, just 4 or 5 lines you can express about my home. Similarly, about my favorite game, you can express your feeling. It is actually a practice of speaking, how to speak, how to express your feelings. That is why the topics, which are very simple, this is of one class level, so that it is just a practice of speaking, so that you may speak your point of view, your thoughts in a free manner. And actually this practice will be done in class, but you can prepare yourself for the coming classes. Let's come to the next page. It's page number 42. There is a semantic map that is given over here. Given below is a map of 3 verbs with 2 responses each about the topic frog. The verb can shows ability, has shows possession, and is stands for factual description. Add at least 2 more responses under each verb. Actually, this is a practice of making sentences. For example, frog can live in water, frog can live on land, frog can jump great distance, frog has big eyes, frog has webbed feet, frog is a good swimmer, frog is found all over the world. So actually this is a practice of making sentences. You can make your own sentences like that also. So make at least 2 sentences in the same manner. So very small exercise just to give you a view how to make sentences. Then we come to the next exercise. This is a modal verb must. Modal verb give meanings to the verbs. Must is used for 2 commands. Number 1, to obey as a rule, and number 2, as an advice. To talk about something that has to be done because it is compulsory. It is absolutely necessary to obey a rule, law, order, or instruction. For example, I must work hard to do well in exams. Number 2, to advise something because it is a good idea. If you visit Karachi, you must go to the seaside. So these are the 2 important functions of modal verb must. There are some others also, but that is not discussed in your book. You have to concentrate only just 2 functions that are main functions that are given here. Now write 5 sentences in each column. Columns are given. This is also a task. It means you have to do that. You can do this task even in your book, in your books. Don't do that in your copies. You can do that in your book. For example, decision that you must take throughout the year. You must obey traffic laws. You must obey classroom rules. You must work hard. You must speak the truth. You must be honest in all the situations. Is it clear? This was all written. This may be written in the first column. You can make your own sentences. These are just examples. You must obey traffic laws. You must obey classroom rules. You must work hard. You must speak the truth. You must be honest, for example. So you have to write the sentences like that in the first column. Now come to the second column. 5 pieces of advice to help your friend. If you want to take rest, you must switch off lights. If you want peace of mind, you must help other people. In this way, you have to write 5 sentences. Is it clear? Now we come to the next. This is creative writing. I think that's enough for today's video. So thank you very much.